Orale.
जिससे
ओके नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी फर्स्ट लुक एट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. हियर सब्जेक्ट, आई इज सब्जेक्ट देन Have oblique has. Have oblique has, or have been, or has been. Have been, or has been. Have been, or. Have been, when to use has been and have been. Singular number, third person, जो he, she, it, my brother, my friend, तो ऐसे singular subject के साथ पेटे singular subjects has been is used. But don't forget, though I is a singular subject, with I we have to use have. You can see in the example, has been is used with he has been, she has been, it has been. Then singular subject like he, she, like my friend, then my brother, with such singular subject we have to use has been. And have been is used with second person, that's you. Have been is used with I, and have been is used with plural subject like friends, people, brothers. Have been is used with I, have been is used with second person, you have been, I have been, then third person plural, they have been, friends have been, brothers have been, this way. So this was the subject, this was the structure of present perfect continuous tense. I have been writing a letter since morning. Then here again, you will see since morning, the time is given. So present perfect continuous tense, ऐसे कार्य हेतु जो कुछ समय पूर्व से लगातार जारी है एवं अभी तक पूर्ण नहीं हुए है, ऐसे कार्य के लिए प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस का इस्तेमाल किया जाता है. द प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस इज यूज्ड फॉर दोज एक्शंस व्हिच हैव स्टार्टेड इन द पास्ट टाइम एंड स्टिल दे आर कंटिन्यू. फॉर एग्जांपल, वो दो घंटे से खेल रहा है, ही हैज बीन प्लेइंग फॉर टू आवर्स, फॉर ही हैज बीन playing for 2 hours. He has been playing for 2 hours. So his playing has started in the past time and still his playing is continuing. When an action is started in the past time and still it continues in the present, to express such actions we have to use present perfect continuous tense. He has been playing for 2 hours. Next, Ram has been writing a book for a month, for a month, for a month. यानी प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूस टेंस का इस्तेमाल ऐसे कार्य के हेतु जो कार्य उस समय पूर्व स्टार्ट हुए थे और अभी तक पूर्ण नहीं हुए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, ही हैज बीन प्लेइंग फॉर टू आवर्स एंड राम हैज बीन राइटिंग अ बुक फॉर अ मंथ. Dear friends, present perfect continuous tense is used to describe an action which began at some time in the past. The action which began at some time in the past and is still continue. The action is continue. For example, I have been riding a bicycle for 2 hours. I have been riding a bicycle for 2 hours. As I have given one example here on your screen, he has been playing for 2 hours. Then one more example of this kind, Ram has been writing a book for a month. Then Raghav has been working since 8 a.m. 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 They have been living here since 1st April 2000. The use of the present perfect continuous tense, they have been playing cricket. So in the third sentence, or in these sentences, you will see the action has started in the past and still the action is going on. Next, we have indicated that the action began sometime in the past. The present perfect continuous is meant for it. We may say, I have been working since yesterday. When the action is started, that time is given. Or for the total period, action is given. He has been playing for 2 hours. For how many hours? The period of time. The total period of time is given in this type of present perfect continuous tense. Or the point of time from which the action began. The point of time is also indicated. Dear friends, for और since के बारे में थोड़ा हम बात करते हैं. Present perfect continuous tense में समय हेतु for और since का प्रयोग किया होता है. For और since. For का प्रयोग period of time, total period of time. For example, for 2 hours, for 15 days, for 10 days, for a long time, for a long period. फॉर सम टाइम, तो ऐसे हेतु किया जाता है. फॉर इंडिकेट्स द टोटल पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, अगेन फॉर इज यूज्ड इन प्रेजेंट परफेक्ट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस फॉर टाइम इंडिकेशन. फॉर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, फॉर टोटल पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, फॉर एग्जाम्पल फॉर 2 hours, फॉर 15 days, फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम, फॉर सम टाइम. सो दिस ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स ऑफ द फ्रेजेस इंडिकेट द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम, द टोटल पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. वेर एज सिंस का इस्तेमाल, द यूज ऑफ सिंस indicates the point of time. It does not indicate the total period of time. It only indicates the point of time from which the action has begun. Here are some words. Since 2 o'clock, since 2 o'clock, since morning, since yesterday, since January, since 1997, since last night. This way. Again, let me tell you, for is used to indicate the period of time, and since is used to indicate a point of time. For example, since 2 o'clock, since morning, since Monday, since January, since 1997. Since last night, etc. Let us see some more examples by using for and since. Ramesh has been living here since 1997. So Rajesh has been living here since 1997. Since 1997. A point of time. Since 1997. Sarla has been teaching in this college since June. Sarla has been teaching in this college Sarla has been teaching in this college since June. A point of time. Sarla has been teaching in this college since June. It has been raining for a long time. It has been raining for a long time. Total period of time. It has been raining for a long time. A long time may be of 2 hours time or 3 hours time or 4 hours time. And Sarla has been teaching in this college since June. A point of time has indicated. And for a total period of time is indicated. I have been studying for 2 hours. I have been studying for two hours. Total period of time. Period of time is given. Not point of time, but total period of time is given. I have been studying for 2 hours. Hema has been dancing for 3 hours. Hema has been dancing for 3 hours. So, dear friends, present perfect continuous tense is used to describe an action which began at some time in the past and is still continuing. Then about for and since. For is used to indicate the period of time, the total period of time. And such indicating words are for 2 hours, for 15 days, for 10 days, for a long time, for a long period, for some time. Since in present perfect continuous tense is used to indicate point of time. It indicates the point of time. Such indicating words are 2 o'clock, since 2 o'clock, since morning, since Monday, since January, since 1997, since last night. Have been is used with I, second person, you, and third person plural number, they. For example, I have been, we have been, you have been, and they have been, and the subject, which are in plural. My friends have been, brothers have been, this way. And has is used with third person singular number. He has been, she has been, it has been. And the subject which is in singular number. My friend has been, my brother has been, this way. Now, dear friends, we have to move to the next tense, and that is past tense. Past tense is divided into or classified into 4 subtenses. One is simple past tense, other is past continuous tense. Past continuous tense is called as past progressive tense also. This doesn't make any difference. Then past perfect tense, past perfect continuous tense. Past tense is classified into simple past tense, past progressive tense or past continuous tense, past perfect tense, and past perfect continuous tense. Let's see the uses of simple past tense. Simple past tense. First, let us see the structure. I wrote a letter. I wrote a letter. I wrote a letter. Subject plus V2. WROT wrote is the second form or the past tense form of verb write. Write, first form, wrote, second form, written, third form, writing, fourth form, and to write, fifth form, that is called the infinitive form of a verb. I wrote a letter. Now, no matter subject is in singular number or plural number, we have to use V2, subject plus V2 plus object. Subject, subject plus V2, subject, and then V2, and then object. Now, if the subject is in singular number or plural number, it doesn't matter. That doesn't make any difference. Simple past tense or in simple past tense, subject plus V2 plus object. Very simple structure. For example, I wrote a letter, we wrote a letter, you wrote a letter, he wrote a letter, she wrote a letter, it wrote a letter, then they wrote a letter. My friend wrote a letter. My friend wrote a letter. My brothers wrote a letter. Whether the subject is in singular or plural, whether the subject is in first person, second person, or third person, it doesn't make any difference. V2, second form of the verb, is used. Dear friend, पास्ट सिंपल पास्ट टेंस का प्रयोग ऐसे वाक्य में होता है जिनमें भूतकाल दर्शाया गया है. फिर एक्शन इज कंप्लीटेड इन द पास्ट. टू एक्सप्रेस सच एक्शंस वी यूज सिंपल पास्ट टेंस. फॉर एग्जांपल, संतोष रोट मी अ लेटर. संतोष रोट मी अ लेटर. दे प्लेड फुटबॉल. दे प्लेड फुटबॉल. दे प्लेड फुटबॉल. They played football. Simple past tense is used to express those actions which are completed in the past. Ravi Shankar ne ek TV kharida. RAVI SHANKAR Ravi Shankar purchased purchased a TV. I wrote a book. He went to Jaipur yesterday. Rajan donated 100 rupees. I helped him. Simple past tense used to express those actions which are completed in the past. Secondly, the time of those actions are also given sometimes. The time of such actions are also given sometimes. For example, an accident took place yesterday. An accident took place yesterday. An accident took place yesterday. He came last night. And when time is not given to express those actions, simple past tense is used. For example, he went to market. I donated 5,000 rupees. So simple past tense used to express those actions which indicates the time and which do not indicate the time also. And very importantly, let me tell you, my dear friend, simple past tense used to express those actions which were the habits in the past time. For our habitual actions in the past, यानी हमारे भूतकाल की जो आदतें हैं, उनको व्यक्त करने के लिए भी सिंपल पास्ट टेंस का इस्तेमाल होता है. Remember this. Simple past tense is used to express those actions which were our habitual actions in the past. भूतकाल की आदत को व्यक्त करने हेतु भी सिंपल पास्ट का प्रयोग किया जाता है. Let me explain this by giving some examples. यानी those habitual actions are not present in the present. Are not happening in the present. Those were our habits in the past time only. For example, he always carried this bag. He always carried this bag. Suppose if whenever he want to go somewhere, He would always carry a particular bag with him. So it was his habit to carry one particular bag with him in the past. He always carried this bag, not any other bag, but this bag only. So it was his habit of carrying one particular bag with him whenever he goes to somewhere in the past. So हमारे भूतकाल की आदत को व्यक्त करने हेतु भी सिंपल पास्ट का प्रयोग किया जाता है. एंड यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दिस. वन मोर एग्जांपल ऑफ दिस टाइप. She never went to church. But now she goes to church. In the past time, she never went to church. पहले या भूतकाल में वो कभी चर्च नहीं जाती थी. But now she goes to church. So to express our habitual actions in the past, we use simple past tense. One more example of this type. He always asked for a cup of tea. 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 So it was his habit of asking the tea or taking the tea. But it was in the past time. Now, he does not ask for a cup of tea. So it was his habit. वो उसकी आदत थी जब वो छोटा था या स्कूल गोइंग स्टूडेंट था तो हमेशा वो चाय का एक कप मांगता. It was his habit. So, to express such habitual actions in the past, we use simple past tense. We use simple past tense. Next, he never missed the train. 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 It was his habit of going to railway station on time. And that's why he never missed the train. वो कभी भी ट्रेन को मिस नहीं करता था. He never missed the train. It was his habit. So, dear friends, to express such habitual actions which were happening in the past time, we use simple past tense. Next, when in direct speech, simple present tense is there, while converting their direct speech into indirect, the simple present tense changes to simple past. Again, let me tell you, if simple present tense is there in the direct speech, it changes to simple past while converting that direct speech into indirect speech. Let me explain this by giving this example. Now look at it. He said,
so less than 1 minute we have.